Thank you. In life, Larry cherished the gospel of Christ. May Christ now greet him with these words of eternal life, "Come, blessed of my Father." And in baptism, he received the sign of the cross. May he now share in Christ's victory over sin and death. So welcome as we gather this morning for the funeral mass of Larry Murray. Thank God for Larry's life. And I suppose we're still in a bit of shock. This day last week, Larry brought his friend on a hospital visit and he had cut the grass at Kenny football field and had ordered more diesel and he had a plan for the future, but in a short time he had become ill and he has died. I suppose these last few days have given us a chance maybe to catch up with the reality of life, but also to catch up about Larry, stories we have heard many times before, but also new stories of Larry and the influence he had on so many people. So we gather today with his wife, Patricia, his children, Mary, Laurence, and Jackie, his grandchildren, his brother Mick, sister Mary, both in Liverpool, joining us online, hopefully, and the people in other places as well, but his in-laws, nieces, nephews, many friends and neighbours. As we gather today, we entrust Larry into the everlasting care of God. We're grateful for all he has meant to us, for the person he has been, the service he has offered to so many, the contribution he has made to many lives. We're grateful for what he means to his family, colleagues and friends, to us who are here today, and for all who join us maybe online, or for all that he will continue to mean to us into the future. We're grateful for his achievements, things we look on and look back on with pride, obstacles faced, challenges overcome, success is won, potential fulfilled. We're grateful for the experiences we've been through together, the love and friendship we have shared, the qualities and characteristics that make Larry special to us. We're grateful here too for his faith, which he celebrated here on a Sunday morning, his commitment to Christ, his discipleship and personal experience of the love of God, and the ways he shared that in this parish community. We're thankful for all that we owe to him, for the many ways he enriched our lives, for the memories we will always have as a lasting tribute and enduring legacy. We gather today in hope and confidence, trusting in God's promise of eternal life, which we think of particularly during this Lent in preparation for Easter. In our faith, we entrust Larry to God and ourselves into God's keeping, and the keeping of this community, of our family and friends. As we begin our Mass, we think of the love we have shared with Larry and in our community and family. So for the times we have offended God or each other, we ask for pardon and forgiveness. You were sent to heal the contrite of heart, Lord, have mercy. You came to call sinners, Christ of mercy. You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, bring us all one day to everlasting life. And let us pray. Eternal God, you made the union of a man and woman a sign of the bond between Christ and his church. Grant peace and mercy to Larry, who was united in love with his wife Trish. May the care and devotion of their lives on earth find lasting reward in heaven. Look kindly on Tricia and her family as they now turn to your compassion and love. Strengthen their faith, lighten their loss. We ask this through Christ our Lord. So now we'll sit and listen to the word of God. That's the first reading and the second reading, please.
This is a reading from the book of the Ecclesiastes. There is a season for everything, and a time for every occupation under heaven. It's a time for giving birth, a time for dying, a time for planting, a time for sprouting what has been planted. It's a time for killing, and a time for healing. It's a time for knocking down, and a time for building. It's a time for tears, and a time for laughter. A time for mourning, and a time for dancing. A time for throwing stones away, and a time for gathering them up. It's a time for embracing, a time to refrain from embracing. And a time for searching, a time for losing. It's a time for keeping, and a time for throwing away. It's a time for tearing, and a time for sowing. It's a time for keeping silent, and a time for speaking. A time for loving, and a time for hating. A time for war, and a time for peace. The word of the Lord.
High Lord of sea and sky,
reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Christ has been raised from the dead, the first fruits of all who have fallen asleep. Death came through one man, and in the same way the resurrection of the dead has come through one man. Just as all men die in Adam, so all men will be brought to life in Christ, but all of them in their proper order. Christ is the first fruits, and then, after the coming of Christ, those who belong to him. The word of the Lord.
So we might stand for the gospel. The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. During the Last Supper, Jesus said to his disciples and friends, I give you a new commandment, that you love one another. Just as I have loved you, you also should love one another. By this everyone will know that you are my disciples. Peace I leave with you, my peace I give to you, a peace the world cannot give. Do not let your hearts be troubled. Trust in God still and trust in me. I came from the Father and have come into the world. Now I am leaving the world and going back to the Father. You are sad now, but I will see you again, and your hearts will rejoice, and no one will take your joy from you. The Gospel of the Lord. Please be seated for a few moments. Over the last number of days, we've told and heard many stories about Larry and his life. And the life of each of us can be thought of as a series of stories that come together over time to form one story, a story that is profoundly ours and absolutely unique. That story is the story of our life, and everybody's story deserves to be listened to and respected. When we know a person's story, we see the person in a friendlier light. If we took the time to get to know each other's stories, we would understand each other better and maybe be kinder to each other. When a person dies, their life story passes before us. It is laid out with its successes and failures, joyful and sorrowful mysteries. It is like a book that is suddenly thrown open for all to read. However, there are no facts about a person that tell the full story of their life. At best, what we have are fragments. The pattern of the life can even escape us sometimes. The full story is known only to God. God sees the heart while we see the surface. The sad fact is that all our stories end in death. And even when death comes naturally at the end of a long and a full life, we do not like a story that ends like that. And this is where the resurrection of Jesus comes in, which we are thinking about during this time of Lent. Jesus conquered death, not by avoiding it, but by passing through it and overcoming it. What happened to Jesus can happen and does happen to us, we believe, in our faith. Jesus' victory over death was won in our human nature. And what happened to the human flesh of Jesus, we believe, will happen to us as well. Our hope of eternal life lies in the resurrection of Jesus. To believe in the resurrection is not to believe in a crazy miracle, but to affirm the power of God, which is greater than the power of death. The resurrection of Jesus opens all our stories to the prospect, not just of a good ending, but of a glorious ending. He has made it possible for us to enter the dark kingdom of death, our hearts buoyed up with the hope of eternal life. So to reflect on Larry's life and the story of his life, which began on the April the 7th, 1948, so he's just short of his 74th birthday. He was born in Brew, across from Newgrange, before the family moved to Stackallan, then to Creewood, where he attended National School. When he finished school, he went to work in the mill in Slane, but he worked in other places after that, Patsy McCabe, Sean Murphy's, Oliver Townsend's and Paul Kiernan's. He worked in the quarry in Lobanstown from 84 to 90. He then transferred to Lagan Works in Dublin, then back to Deligue, and was back in Lobanstown from 2018. He worked hard and was good company with plenty, as you can imagine, of GAA banter. He married Patricia in August 1971. He provided well for her and his children. They were in close contact with cousins and have lovely memories of summers in Mayo, but a great connection with their cousins and with their broader family. He was very proud of his family and showed great interest in all that they did, from football to cars, bicycles, and travelling the country to practices and fashiona. He travelled to Germany to visit his grandchildren, and in recent years went an important visit to him to see his brother Paddy in Canada before Paddy died. Family was very important to Larry. His major interest in life was GAA, especially Rathkenny GAA and Meath GAA. He was a member of Rathkenny GAA for 40 years. Just wondering myself, between calculations, what was he doing for the other 34 years? But didn't get to ask that question. He was chairman for 15 years, treasurer, selector of junior championship winning teams in 96 and 99, a linesman and umpire. And when Larry particularly, I think, was an umpire, you didn't need Hawkeye. There was only one way that score was going. But he was a steward, and he was the current vice-treasurer and president of the club. He was chairman when Rakenny won the intermediate title in 2006. It was a very special time, and we were just talking last night that they used to say on the bus coming home, there's only one Larry Murray. Then they realised suddenly there was two Larry Murrays. But I suppose the sad part about today is we're back to the one Larry Murray, so it hits us a bit hard, always, these things. He was overseer of the FOSS scheme in the club, coordinated getting jobs done and acquired sponsorship. He was on the committee that established the lotto, I think in 92. He cut the grass on the pitch last week, and it said he'd ordered diesel with plans to cut more. He was county board delegate for the club and a matchday steward in Park Talton. He went to all the Mead games and was a wizard at sourcing tickets. He attended many funerals, I suppose, through these connections as well, and I suppose we think of the past 2 years and the challenges that that brought to him personally in family life, but also in, I suppose, that attending funerals and sympathising with people and letting people know that they were in his thoughts and in his concern. But he did other things as well. He was interested in pool, rings and darts. He represented Mead at rings, and in spite of getting many 20 finals in darts, never quite won a cup. He followed horse racing a bit and always appreciated a good tip from his brothers in England. So there are many things I haven't mentioned, music there either, and many other things. And as I said at the start, maybe we all have our memories and different parts of the picture and the story of him. He was a great family man, but a community man. For GAA, he worked hard. He was witty and a good person to be around. We're grateful to have shared his life, enriching his life, but also the ways that he enriched ours. His 50 years of marriage and 40 years membership of Rakenny GAA stand out, but there is much more to him, as we know. For those who worked with him or knew him around Rakenny Hall or as a steward or a parishioner here at Mass on a Sunday, we're glad that he lived a full life, and we deeply appreciate the tender care shown to him in his last hours and appreciate the fact that his family could be with him when he died. We appreciate the stories, as said, retold, but the new stories we've heard over these last days of his long goodbye. Thanks to all who called or contacted, those who stayed away when they were sick maybe, stewards, tea makers, and all who have helped. But when the flags go back from half-mast and the postponed matches are replayed, this is a major loss for Trish and her family. We pray and support them as best we can and thank them for sharing Larry with so many people and bringing about so much good in our community. But Larry showed the benefit of being involved for ourselves and in the challenging world we live in, to be involved in committees, to be doing work in the background, and in our time of struggle and as we come out of this time of was cocooning and all of the isolation, we ask that we too might be able to work together for the good of community and family life. Just to reflect a little on the readings, there's a time for everything. I suppose Larry died just before summertime, and I suppose the long evenings of matches and all of those things. We think of all the planting, the building, the healing, the laughter and the dancing, as well as the mourning and tears. Talking about gathering stones, we think of his work in the quarry. The refraining from embracing, it talks about too, which we've experienced over this past time, and we'll try to be careful today as we express our sympathy. And I suppose at a meeting or in life, you learn from the GAA, it's a time to be silent and a time to speak. The difference then one person makes is what we hear in the second reading of, was that we think of the difference Larry made, but the difference that all of us make, whether in a big way, but also sometimes in small ways as well. And then the gospel, which comes back to the central part of what we are thinking of today, and that's love. Love of 50 years of marriage, love of family, the connections that are there, and we ask the Lord to help us to continue to love, to care, and support Trish, the family, and each other. So with these and other things in mind, we have now our prayers, the faithful. So whoever's doing them, please, might come up. Yeah.
Just going to leave it here. We pray for our father and grandfather Larry. In baptism, he was given the pledge of eternal life. May he now be admitted to the company of the saints. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
We pray in thanksgiving for all the blessings that came to so many people through the life of Larry. May he now receive the fullness of God's blessings in eternity. Lord, hear us.
We pray for all our departed brothers and sisters. Today we pray for Larry's parents, Thomas and Mary, his brothers Benny, John, Noel, Vincent and Paddy, and sisters Bridie and Nellie. May Larry be reunited with them in God's kingdom, where there is no more pain and suffering. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
We pray for the nurses and doctors and carers of Our Lady's Hospital in Navan, and the ICU in the Mater Hospital in Dublin for their patience and kindness shown to Larry in his final hours. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
We pray for all who are gathered here in worship. May our own lives bear witness to the generous love of the Lord who lived, died, and rose from the dead so that we may have life and have it to the full. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
May the God of all consolation be with all who are in sorrow and mourning the loss of Larry. May he give them courage and strength to live through this time of suffering which has been laid upon them, and give them a deep peace which only he can give. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
We pray for innocent people in Ukraine and around the world harmed by violence or instability. May God bless and console them. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
Larry touched all our lives. Help us to keep alive the values and the ideals he put before us. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us. Pray for our own intention today. Pray for our families, our community, the challenges that our world faces, for those who are making important decisions about our present and future. Lord, hear us. God, our Father, these are our prayers, spoken and unspoken. We ask you to grant them through Christ our Lord. So now we have an offertory procession. We have different symbols of Larry's life. So I think Larry is going to tell us what they are.
Thank you. Hi, everyone. Just a few special items in Larry's life, being brought up by some special people in Larry's life. We have Aaron coming up with a hard hat, symbolising Larry's work in Lagans and elsewhere over the last 32 years. Any time you want, lads. Me jersey. We have Joe Farrell coming up with the Meade jersey. Joe and Larry went to many a Meade game back in the day, the good days and the bad days. Paul Smith is coming up with Larry's darts jersey. As you heard earlier, played for many a year, never quite won anything in it, but darts isn't just for winning, it's just for having a bit of crack as well, I suppose. We've David Heary coming up with Rick Kenny jersey. Larry, member of the club for the last 40 years, chairman for 15. Great times he was had by all, and Larry really, really loved this club. John Maloney coming up with the Canada photo album. John and Larry went to Canada 3 years ago to see my Uncle Paddy, and they had a mighty time there by all accounts, and just before Paddy unfortunately passed away. We have the two youngest grandchildren, Oisin Maloney and Owen Murray, bringing up the photograph of the family vacation or holiday in Wexford last year and the family tree pillow. We've Gavin Maloney coming up with Larry's torn screw, as he calls it. Everyone else calls it a screwdriver. This symbolises Larry's last few years be down in Gavin's shed fixing grandchildren's cars and, of course, the infamous lawnmower. We have Saoirse coming up with dance shoes. Larry's two daughters, three grandkids are all very, very good at Irish dancing, and our Saoirse herself will be taking part in the world next week. And last, you have Sean McElerney, owner of the local pub, Sally Gardens, where Larry liked to spend a few nights, starting off, of course, with a brandy. And there's his brandy glass. And whatever you do, do not get the mixture wrong. Many a time he was in the Sally, discussing sport, news, might be a little bit of gossip, and also having a few drinks. Thanks very much.
Thank you.
pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours will be acceptable to God, our Almighty Father. Look favorably on our offerings, O Lord, so that Larry may be taken up into glory with your Son, in whose great mystery of love we are all united, through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Almighty, eternal God, through Christ our Lord. In him, the hope of a blessed resurrection has dawned, that those saddened by the certainty of dying might be consoled by the promise of immortality to come. Indeed, for your faithful people, Lord, life is changed, not ended, and when this earthly dwelling turns to dust, an eternal dwelling is made ready for them in heaven. So with the angels and saints and the hosts of heaven, we join the hymn of your glory as we say, Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, he broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more, giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. When we eat this bread, drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life, the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church and people spread throughout the world. Bring her to the fullness of love, together with Francis, our Pope, Tom, our Bishop, and all your people. Remember Larry, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that he who was united with your Son in a death like his may also be one with him in his resurrection. Remember our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Larry's parents, Thomas and Mary, his brothers, Benny, John, Noel, Vincent and Paddy, sisters Bridie and Nellie. May their souls and the souls of all the faithful departed rest in peace. Welcome them all into the light of your face, and have mercy on us, we pray, Lord, that with Mary, the Mother of God, Joseph, her spouse, the apostles, saints, and all who pleased you throughout the ages, that we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honour is yours forever and ever. At the Saviour's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver and protect us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin, safe from all distress as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Amen. Glory are yours now and forever, Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church. graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Let's pray for a moment for peace. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof. Only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. So please be seated. So just for communion, bring communion to the Trish and the Chief Mourn at first, and then just start with the block on my left. If you come up along the wall, please, if you wish to receive, and go back, do a circular round. Then this block here, on my left, your right, center block, come up the center, go back the sides, block here then, come up the center, go back the sides, and find this block along the wall and back up the center.
And if wicked men Then sings my song.
So let us pray. God of endless ages, from one generation to the next, you are our refuge and our strength. Look with love now on Larry, whose life was spent in your service and in the service of others. Give him a place in your kingdom where hope is firm for all who love and rest is sure for all who serve. We ask this through Christ our Lord. So on your behalf, my own behalf, and just extend sympathy again to Trish and her family and for all. I said earlier, I think that Mick and Mary weren't here. They're here in case anyone gets a shock when you see them later. So, but thanks to all of yourselves for coming to support the family today, but also over the last number of days, and for all who made it possible, the stewards and those who made tea and all of those things, those who did guards of honour, respect for Larry. So in a few moments we'll have our final prayers, and then we'll have an opportunity to sympathise, and I suppose it's to be careful, please. COVID is still about, and for one of us to mind ourselves, not too bad, but when you have a number of people interacting and sympathising, and I know our natural reaction is to embrace that, but maybe just think a little bit if that's possible. But thank you for coming. Thank you for support to the family and that support that will be there into the future as well. So the Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless and protect us all, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Before we go our separate ways, we take leave of Larry. May our farewell express our love for him. May it help ease our sadness and strengthen our hope. One day we will joyfully greet Larry again, when the love of Christ, which conquers all things, destroys even death itself. So now we pray in silence for Larry as we sprinkle his coffin again with holy water, a reminder of his baptism, and also use the incense, a sign of our love and care for him and his dignity as a person. Our response is, receive his soul and present him to God the Most High. Receive his soul and present him to God the Most High. Saints of God, come to his aid. Hasten to meet him, angels of the Lord. Receive his soul and present him to God the Most High. May Christ, who called you, take you to himself. May angels lead you to Abraham's side. Receive his soul and present him to God the Most High. Eternal rest grant unto him, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon him. Receive his soul and present him to God the Most High. Into your hands, Father of mercies, we commend Larry, in the sure and certain hope that together with all who have died in Christ, he will rise with him on the last day. We give you thanks for the blessings you gave to Larry in life and the blessings that you gave to us through him. They are signs to us of your goodness and of our fellowship with the saints in Christ. Merciful Lord, turn toward each of us today and listen to our prayers. Open the gates of paradise to Larry. Help us who remain to comfort each other with faith until we all meet again in Christ and we are with you and with Larry forever. So now in peace, we take Larry to his place of rest.
Thank you. beautiful county of me.
Fishing down on the boy, I remember.